and Judi Dench were expecting in the midweek movie at 9:35 tonight here on RTE1. Now, though, Scotty shares his secret in Shortland Street.
I'm all out of people, so could you mind doing for us?
I'm pretty wet.
Half an hour tops.
What happened?
I don't know. I fell asleep. I'm sorry.
You and me may as well have dug the graves ourselves and chucked him in there.
Oi, Hunter, back off.
Not until he admits he's as much to blame as I am.
Shut your mouth! You shut your damn mouth!
Scotty, don't! Wait, dude, let's bring this up, man. Nobody is looking for a fight.
Scotty, come on, let's go outside. Hun? You right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Hunter?
Only just. You were getting ready to slug me. What was that about?
I don't know.
Look, he's had a stressful day. There's a lot going on. Can you just give us a minute? A couple of coffees would be good.
Coming right up.
Did you see those army trained reflexes? He had you pinned, man.
Well, I didn't see it coming. I was talking to him and it came out of nowhere.
Talking? Dude, you were haranguing him. I would have punched you.
Yeah, haranguing him about what and why here? Haven't I got enough problems?
I was talking to him about Dylan and HDU. I told Scotty it was his fault as much as it was mine. I was too tired to work. He shouldn't have left me in charge of anyone.
So you were trying to shift the blame. Is that supposed to make you feel better?
It did. For a second, it did. And you know why Scotty went off the way he did? Because I'm right. That's why.
Except you know what tomorrow is? No, you wouldn't. And I only know because Dad's got it marked on the calendar at home. A year since Shanti died.
Oh, hell.
Could be. That's why Scotty flipped out. You standing there blaming him for someone dying?
That's what Tracy meant when she said there's a lot going on. I feel worse than terrible. I'm gonna go see him.
No,
I was bruising for a fight. I wound him up.
Yeah, and the best thing you can do is give him a couple of minutes to wind down, don't you think?
A decision on the Kendall ground is well overdue. End of last week, Callum said.
Yes, I know. I've been looking into it.
He hinted that I was pretty much top of the list, so you can understand why I'm keen to know the outcome.
Well, actually, I've been thinking of extending the deadline for applications and widening the criteria.
Why?
Well, 25,000 is a pretty generous sum, and the CVs we've had so far are no great shakes.
Sarah, am I top of the list or not?
At this stage, yes.
But rather than give me the grant, which I've obviously won outright, you're shifting the goalposts so someone else can get in ahead of me. I'd be forgiven for taking that personally, don't you think?
I'm just trying to ensure that the money goes to the best possible applicant. At the end of the day, that may still be you.
But not if you have anything to do with it. Top marks for fairness, boss.
Shane, this is Dr. Brooke Freeman. Brooke, this is Shane Tucker from the DHB.
Hi.
Good evening.
Sorry you had to see that. A classic Brooke hissy fit.
Why aren't you giving her the grant?
She's got next to no research experience.
Yet she's the front runner.
Somehow, yes.
You suspect she's cheated?
Oh, I know what she's like. When she sets her sights on something, she makes sure she gets it, whatever it takes.
That sounds like a veiled accusation to me, mixed in with a bit of grudge. Have you got any proof she's fiddled her application?
Well, it seems straight up. I just don't understand why no one more worthy has applied.
Her good luck, maybe. You're CEO now. Your decisions have to stand up to scrutiny, so I'd firmly advise you to keep things professional.
I wanted to clear the air over Dylan, but Hunter tried to push the blame onto me. Wouldn't let up. He kept going on and on about it.
Because he's struggling. He's young and he feels guilty, and you know all this because you've seen it time and again.
I know.
Is this about Shanti? I know the meeting with the Kumars went well today, but...
Yeah, that'll be it. You're right. It's stressing me out more than I realised.
Hey there. These are on me to say sorry for. Before, I was totally out of line in there.
And I overreacted. Let's forget about it, eh?
Can I just say I don't blame you for Dylan, but I just feel so bad about things.
I said forget it.
Scotty, what are you doing?
Going home. I'll see you there.
Scotty.
I just keep stuffing things up with him, don't I?
It's not you. It's something else. It's not you.
You do what you have to do, Miss CEO.
Hi, Dan.
Hey. Pizza. All right. See you when we see you. Love ya.
Is Mum still at work?
Yeah, but she said she's fine. So all we can do is support her. Hey, do you want to put some plates out? Dylan will be here in a sec.
Yeah. Do you want to catch a movie tomorrow?
Aren't you at school?
Teacher only day.
Right, well, I'm working. Got a shift as a lawyer.
How did you manage that? Sarah didn't think it'd be a good look if she hired you 5 minutes into her new job.
Well, I've got friends in high places.
Who?
Shane Tucker, the DHB guy. Yeah, I sorted his computer for him, and he was so impressed, he asked Mum to take me on.
The nerd coming to the rescue.
He's not a nerd.
Well, no, sure am. Out and proud.
Cool. Could you come home tomorrow, help me with my computer homework?
I'll be too busy.
Be careful then. I'll bring my homework.
Isn't that just as boring as doing it here?
I'll deal.
You'll have to ask your Mum, see what she says.
She won't mind. Maybe I'll see you for coffee.
Maybe.
If they re-advertise for the Kendall grant, one of the other applicants is bound to start asking questions. How long until Sarah figures out that mine is the only CV that hasn't been tampered with?
We can't let that happen. You have to work on her, convince her you're a changed woman. You have to make her give you that grant.
After the way we left things tonight, no chance.
What's your alternative, Brooke? To destroy the tampered CVs? It's not just Sarah's copies. They're on Leo's hard drive, which are now in the hands of some DHB suit. If he starts making connections...
Shane Tucker.
Hmm?
The DHB guy, I just met him. He appointed Sarah, right?
Yeah, so what?
Good morning. It's Shane, isn't it? We met briefly last night.
Yes, I remember. How are you, Brooke?
Oh, still clumsy, obviously.
Allow me, please. Your research for the Kendall grant?
A magnesium nebulizer treatment for asthma and emphysema.
Topical subject?
And vital. It's a safe and inexpensive treatment that could help thousands.
Noble too.
If you say so.
And from what I heard last night, you're the front runner for the grant.
Not if Sarah has her way. We have some checkered personal history.
Which has no relevance here.
If that were the case, I wouldn't still be waiting for a decision. I hate waiting. For anything.
Then maybe I can hurry things along for you. Leave it with me.
Are you going to talk to me before we go?
About what?
About what's going on in your mind about last night with Hunter and... What
you know what that was, what today is.
Yeah, but you were really happy after your meeting with the Kumars. It was after that...
So now you're calling me a liar?
No, it just seems like there's something else, something that you're not...
There's
really...
nothing. Take my word for it.
Hey, Dan. What are you doing?
Right now? Taking a patient to radiology.
Can I help? I could keep them company while they wait, get the magazines and stuff. I wouldn't mind.
Daniel's working, Ola. Leave them to it, hey? Off you go, you. Oh, so that's why you were so keen to come in here? Give it up, hon. He is way too old for you.
Activity pack? This is just stuff you fished out of the recycling bin.
No, it's what I could find in a hurry.
Why do I have to hang out here anyway?
Because I don't want you home alone and I have to work, like now. Hey, Wendy, I've got the perfect solution for two girls at a loose end.
What?
House cleaning. My place.
As if.
I think Jasmine will be fine here.
What's the pay like?
$10.
That's way below minimum wage.
Jasmine, I didn't even say you were allowed to go.
Come on, Mum. What would you rather I do, waste time with old magazines or learn the value of earning my own money?
She makes a good point.
And so do I. I'm not doing it.
Yes, you are. $15, my final offer.
Deal.
Happy cleaning, you two.
You won't even recognize the place.
Have you heard about the Kendall Research Grant?
Oh, I think I've seen it advertised somewhere ages ago. Why? Is it still open for applications?
Mm, the deadline's been extended. Are you interested?
$25,000. Might be.
Is this the Kendall Grant?
Yeah. You interested too?
I didn't know it was open to surgical applications.
It wasn't. When I extended the deadline, I widened the criteria to ensure that
Didn't Brooke apply under the old criteria?
Her project will still be considered.
Except the rules have changed. Seems a bit unfair to me. I'll pass, thanks.
Thanks for thinking of me. I'm probably a bit too stretched.
It's a bit unnerving when the CEO changes the rules instead of enforcing them fairly. It's not the sort of reputation I'd want if I were you.
H-O-F-S-T-E-T-T-E-R. Thank you. Really? You're sure she called from here? When was this? Did she give her name? Thank you. You've been very helpful. Just a computer whiz kit I ordered.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
Very droll. I'm having access issues.
Job of logging on. Well, let's see.
Routine part of my investigation.
Right. Maybe you should call IT.
There's snowed under, worse than yesterday, and I'm sure this won't keep you from your orderly duties for more than a minute or two.
About as long as it will take me to get fired if I'm found out.
I won't tell.
Yeah, believe me, IT have their ways.
So that's a no.
Sorry, I can't hack into someone's user account, especially not Callum McKay's.
I can't argue with a man of principles.
This place is nice. My mum does her best, but she's got gross taste. Hola. Is that a What Will Our Baby Look Like website?
No, it's not. Go tidy something.
Yes, it is. And that's Daniel Potts. You so like him.
As if. I'm just mucking around.
He's your dad's girlfriend's son. Doesn't that kind of make him your brother?
Shut up. Go clean.
So you can sit on the internet and drool over Daniel Potts. That's so funny. Okay, I'm cleaning. But you have to do the vacuuming.
Why? You suck already, so you're a natural.
It gives me asthma.
Just go away.
Whatever, Mrs. Potts.
The research grant. Where are you with that?
Interesting, you should ask. I've decided
give it to Brooke Freeman. With an apology.
Is that an order? Because I didn't realise it was your decision to make.
You have a multi-million dollar hospital to run. Yet all I see is you wasting time on a 25 grand research grant. Give it to Freeman and move on. Or I might start questioning your appointment. Shall we sign off on the paperwork now?
I was just about to, as soon as I finished my tea.
Tanya, hey.
Hey, Hunter. How are you doing?
Okay.
Nicole told me about the patient in HDU. I'm really sorry you had to go through that.
Have you spoken to Tracy today?
Yeah. Her and Scotty have the morning off.
Yeah, I was just wondering, do you think it would be a good idea to go round, take some flowers or something?
Yeah, I'm sure Scotty would be really touched.
You think? Because I just feel so terrible about adding to his grief, you know, blaming him for my mistake, and it was my mistake, not his.
We all make them.
Yeah.
Hunter, are you sure you're going to be right?
I'll have to be, won't I?
The grant is yours if you still want it.
Of course I do. Thank you.
Look, I know we've had our personal differences, but you're making the right decision, believe me.
Our differences are irrelevant. This is a professional call based on the quality of the applications. And since I have decided against shifting the goalposts, as you put it, yours is the best one we have. So, the acceptance contract, as soon as you sign it and return it, the money will be transferred to your account.
Great.
And please accept my apology for dragging this process out.
Well, I don't blame you, really. It must be tough entrusting a research grant to a newbie like me.
Just make every dollar count, Brooke. That's all I ask.
I will. Thank you again.
How about I make us a cuppa?
After all that chai? Couldn't.
Me neither. That was good though, huh?
Yeah, it was.
A few tears, a few laughs, lots of memories. You look done in. How about you crash on the couch and catch up on some of the sleep you missed last night?
I might do that.
Meanwhile, I am going to go shopping. This fridge looks scarily empty.
Okay.
Do you want me to add anything to the list?
No.
Okay. See you soon.
have keys?
Scotty. I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
No, I'm pathetic.
No, you're not. You told me last night you were finding it difficult dealing with the anniversary, and I stupidly suggested it was something else, as if you need anything else. She was your wife.
Tracy, I'm not the man you...
Don't. Okay? You're grieving all over again. And that happens. It's okay.
Great job on the vacuuming. Your mum's gonna want her money back when she sees this floor.
Okay, you go get it, I'll do it.
Why do I have to get it out? You haven't done anything except for make babies with Daniel Potts.
Shut up! If you tell anyone about that ever, you'll be sorry.
Maybe I will, maybe I won't. Where's the stupid vacuum cleaner?
In there. Maybe that'll teach you to keep your mouth shut.
No, Sonny, it'll let me out.
Really, Sonny, and no.
Please, I can't.
I said shut up. That's better. Keep practicing.
The groceries can wait, but I might bring the washing in before it starts to rain.
Go for it. I'm fine now. I didn't know what to bring around, so something for the garden.
Thanks. Come in, we just got back from a memorial service.
Yeah, I'm not gonna talk about Dylan or anything. I just wanted to make sure that you and me are okay.
I'm not okay. I'm ashamed of the way I attacked you. I had no excuse.
Oh, yes, you did, Shanti.
No, it wasn't about Shanti. None of it is. That's what shames me the most, that I'm using her memory to cover my own weakness.
I don't follow.
I keep losing it, Hunter. Not just at you, at everyone, and anything can set it off. Before it was a pile of books falling on the floor, the noise set me off into a full-blown panic attack. It's pathetic.
How long has this been happening?
It's about Penny. You don't have to tell me that. That's the thing. I understand it, but there's nothing I can do to stop it.
Well, why don't you go see someone? You know, get some help.
I know post-traumatic stress symptoms back to front better than any Ferndale counsellor. And what happened with Penny is nothing compared to being in a war zone. It's ridiculous to react like this.
What does Tracy think?
She doesn't know, and I'm not going to tell her.
Why not?
Because I'll get over it. I just need some time. What I don't need is her watching me, looking for cracks that aren't there, you understand? Between us.
Sure.
Hey, Hunter.
Hi.
He brought us a plant.
That's really thoughtful, thank you.
No, it's nothing.
How are you holding up? You sleeping all right?
I'm getting there. I should be off. Take care of yourself, all right?
You too.
See you, Trace.
So you two all sorted then?
Yeah. Yeah, we are.
Listen, all this stuff you're feeling, it's not going to go away overnight. So you have permission to be snappy for the next little while. Although I will definitely tell you when your time is up.
I've signed the contract. Money will be in my account tonight.
No need to thank me. I'm happy to be of help anytime.
What did you do?
I told Sarah to pull a hidden and give you the grant in the nicest possible way. Seems like it worked.
You're a sweetheart.
I'm just glad you'll be in party mode tonight.
Count on it. Oh, I've just been given the green light for the research grant by Sarah.
Good for you.
And I assume I have you to thank.
You do, which only adds to my disappointment. You knew Hofstede was a fraud, yet you didn't tell anyone.
I had my suspicions, but nothing concrete.
That's funny. Two HR execs from two European hospitals say they were contacted by Dr. Freeman regarding Leo Hofstede's references. They both told her they'd never heard of him. This was the day before the theft.
I swear, I had no idea.
It sounds to me like you were in on the deal, Brooke. So give me one good reason why I shouldn't call the police.
You still alive in there, Jasmine? Good work on the shutting up practice. It might almost be time to let you out. Hey, did you fall asleep or something? Jasmine, are you okay? Where's your stupid inhaler? Here, take this, you'll be fine. Have another puff, Jasmine! Okay, I'll call an ambulance. Just wait, okay? This is not my fault. I never knew your asthma was that bad. Yes, ambulance! Hurry!
He was blackmailing you. How?
I can't say. It's personal and embarrassing. But I swear I didn't know he was a thief. I swear it.
I like you, Brooke. The last thing I want is to see you in trouble.
I knew Leo's references were false. That's all.
I believe you. You're a victim in this, unlike Callum Mackay. You told him about Hofstetter, didn't you?
No.
You told him and he did nothing. Because his girlfriend hired Hofstetter and he didn't want to expose her as incompetent. Isn't that what happened?
You want me to lie? You won't call him out.
Nugent, Mackay, McKenna. Together they grossly mishandled the public-private transition, which I'd personally rubber-stamped right to ministerial level. Yes, I want them out.
So what happens to me?
I reward loyalty, Brooke. I know you want to get ahead. So how does 2IC sound? With a salary hike to match. All you have to do is hurry the inevitable and help me get Callum out. Have a think about it.
Find out if Brooke can be bought tomorrow morning at 10 to 11, but tonight everything's homemade from scratch. Rachel Allen's baking all things sweet for a delicious afternoon tea at 8:30 here on RTE1. Next today, Kevin and Sigourney play doctors and nurses. That's after the break.
Kathleen's back from her...